Hi, I'm Dave, KG0ZZ. I've been a licensed amateur radio operator since 1993, and my favorite part of the hobby is building antennas. Hello again and welcome. Thank you for joining me. In today's video, we're going to build an HF ground plane antenna. And I've got the parts laid out here on the table here in front of me, and I'll show you those here in just a moment. I also have a little 70 centimeter ground plane antenna. I'm going to use this here for just a moment to kind of explain a little bit about the ground plane antenna. Ground plane antennas, of course, are vertical antennas. We can make them in a lot of different sizes. This is a small one for 70 centimeters. You can make them for 2 meters, 6, all the way 10 through 40 meters. We get to 80 and 160. The antennas are a bit tall and we have to find a way to shorten the vertical element. But they're simple little antennas that are pretty easy to make and easy to understand. The center of the coaxial cable connects to the main radiating element, and the shield side, of course, connects to the radials. In theory, the antenna is a quarter wavelength tall and the radials are one quarter wavelength long. And you can use the formula for a dipole 468 to calculate the total length of a half wave and then divide that in half to find a quarter wave. Or very simply put, you could use the number 234, which is half of 468. 234 divided by the frequency in megahertz gives you one quarter wavelength. And now that's in theory. In practice, though, sometimes our elements tend to be a lot longer than the calculated quarter wavelength that it's supposed to be. And we'll get to that. I'll kind of demonstrate that whenever I go to set up this antenna. Primarily, these antennas are for ground wave propagation. Normally, we put these up on a mast as high as possible. And you know, that will increase the ability for the antenna to send and receive a farther distance. And so really mounted up on a mast and as high as possible is where the ground plane antenna really works best. Now, depending on the purpose, you know, now if you're building a CB antenna, of course you want it mounted on a mast and you want it up as high as possible. But if you're building the antenna to work DX, it does not necessarily have to be mounted on a mast. It can be mounted on the ground. You see, the ground plane antenna, and you're going to hear me refer to this as a vertical or vertical antenna, the ground plane antenna, it, you know, primarily is for ground wave propagation, but it also makes a good DX antenna. And the reason for that is because it has a very low angle of takeoff. Its radiation pattern, it's an omnidirectional pattern, but unlike a horizontal dipole sends a signal up at an angle and we try to bounce the signal off the ionosphere. Whereas the ground plane antenna, it also bounces off the ionosphere, but what it does, it sends its signal farther out across towards the horizon and before it bounces. And so you actually get a little farther hop with a vertical antenna. So they're great, great for DX antennas too. Now, if you want to build one for the CB band, again, mounted up on a mast, make sure you ground the antenna. I had a 20 meter vertical antenna that was elevated about 11 feet off the ground. It was mounted on PVC pipe. It was not grounded. And let me tell you, whenever a thunderstorm got within about 10 miles, that antenna turned into a large static electricity collector. And it, with the cable disconnected inside the ham shack, you could just see the bright blue spark arcing across between the center and the shield. So make sure you ground the antennas if you mount these up on a mast. And please, let me talk a moment here just about safety. A couple of years ago here locally, we had a couple of guys, a father and his middle-aged son were putting up a ground-mounted vertical out in the backyard. It was a large ham radio antenna, and they did come in contact with a power line, and it did kill both of them. So please, please do not put up antennas near power lines So whenever you're looking for a location, I've been trying to figure out where I'm going to put this antenna at, but the best spot in the yard is it's got a power line right next to it, so I'm going to have to put it over on the other side of the house. So that's part of your considerations for where you're going to mount the ground plane antenna. So let's go ahead and get to the parts, and I'll show you how we're going to do this. I am going to build a ground-mounted 10-meter vertical. And when we mounted them on the ground, whatever piece of pipe or mast section that you have down in the ground, hopefully that's enough to actually ground the antenna. If it's not, then you might want to get a ground rod and put that down right beside this and tie off the radials and the shield side of the coaxial connector. So, but you're going to need a piece of mast or a piece of steel water pipe or something. This one is about 28 inches long. It's not real long. If I'm building a bigger antenna, I might want a longer piece of pipe to stick in the ground, but for this 10-meter antenna, this should be long enough. So let's get to the other parts here. Now for the main vertical element, I have three pieces of aluminum tubing. These are left over from another project. They've already been notched out and they've got hose clamps on the ends of them. These are 4 foot long and they go from 3/4 inch, let's see, they're 3/4 inch, 5/8 and 1/2 inch T6061 aluminum tubing. And then for a mounting plate, I have a piece of 3/16 inch aluminum flat bar, and it's 3 inches wide, and this piece is about 8 inches long, and for the small antenna this should be tall enough for a bracket. Here are U-bolts. I've got U-bolts along with flat washers and lock washers and nuts for those. I'm going to need two more flat washers also. I'm going to connect, I'm going to use these for the vertical element. I've got a piece of PVC pipe, and I've already taken the Dremel tool and just kind of put a couple of big wide notches in the PVC pipe. That's about 10 inches long. And this is my main bottom section of aluminum tubing is going to fit down inside of it. I'm going to use a hose clamp and clamp it off. Then this is going to be clamped off like this to the aluminum flat bar. And then, of course, I've got two clamps here to mount it on the mast. The mast, that's going to go in the ground. I need to leave about 8 to 10 inches sticking up out of the ground, and so I'm going to have to drive this down to the ground to mount the antenna. The radials here, I've cut four pieces of wire, 8 feet 4 inches, which and then I've stripped 1 inch of 1 inch of insulation off of the ends of the wire here too. So the total calculated length was 8 feet 3 inches, and so I've made them 1 inch longer. 2.54 meters is the length on those. For the feed point, we're just going to I've got a scrap piece of coaxial cable. I'm going to see if I can use that and split the end of the coaxial cable. I'm going to use a ring connector for the shield side of the coaxial cable. And if you're doing this and you're putting it up, you know, kind of semi-permanently, here's a ring connector and a sheet metal screw and a lock washer. And you could do the center like that, drill a hole in the end of the tubing and mount the coaxial cable directly to it with the tubing. And now I don't really want to drill a hole in my tubing here because I'm, you know, probably going to reuse it for another project. So I'm just going to take another hose clamp and clamp the center conductor of the coaxial cable to the end of the tubing. But that's it. The parts are really very simple. Also, in addition to the radials here, I've got a box of, or part of a box of some landscaping staples. And it's just a wire staple that I plan on using to hold the radials down on the ground in place. The radials can either be left on top of the ground and the grass can grow over it, or the radials can be buried in the ground, you know, a couple of inches. You can use a claw hammer or something and dig a trench and you can bury the radials. This is another advantage of mounting it on the ground is you don't have all of the radials to mow around. If you put this on a mast, you're going to need either three or four radials if you put it on a mast, and then of course you'll make these a little bit longer. You'll have to add 6 to 8 inches and then put an insulator on it and add a piece of rope and tie off the radials. And have fun mowing around the radials, because I know what that's like and it's no fun. So mounted on the ground, it's pretty much maintenance, I can't say maintenance free, but it's a whole lot easier to take care of, a whole lot easier to mow around. I still have the metal mounting bracket to make up, and the U-bolts that I'm using are wide enough. They're a little bit wider than the pipe, but they're wide enough to clear what's going to be on the other side of it, and then that way I can mount the two different sizes of pipe. Cover this with some tape just to mark some lines on it. Okay, I'm going to mark one end, the top, and then I'm going to start from the bottom here. I'm going to go about an inch up for the first U-bolt, and I'm going to mark it at 2 inches, like that. And then at the top, I'm going to come down, I'm going to mark it at a half an inch, and come down 1.5 inches, mark it at a half inch or 1.5 inches at the top. Draw some lines across here. Okay, the U-bolts, if you want to, you can just lay them up there. Find the center. See where that's at. It's about a half inch. And that's about a half an inch. So a half inch from the ends. Take the awl, go ahead and mark the holes. I'm going to start with a 1/8 inch drill bit and then work my way up to 5/16ths of an inch. Here is what the base of the antenna is going to look like. Here it is put together. There's the aluminum mounting bracket, and you can see the mast that's going to go in the ground is going to be mounted to it with the U-bolts going in that direction. On the other side, I've got the PVC pipe insulator. My U-bolts were a little bit too long for this piece of pipe, so I've got a little piece of aluminum underneath there for a shim. So I've got that good and snug now. This part here with the additional clamp may be optional. If you use the right size U-bolts, you might be able to just go ahead and clamp the tubing with the PVC pipe and using just the U-bolts And so this is kind of optional, but this is how I kind of planned it out. Connections, coaxial connections, radial connections, pretty easy. I'm going to take the radials. We're going to bend, this is the bottom, this is the top. And we're going to take the radials and bend an eye hook in the ends of them here. And then we'll take that and attach, I'm going to put two on this side, and I'll put two on this side. And then the shield for my coaxial cable, it's also going to go on one of these bolts along with that. And I've put an extra flat washer on these two, or on this U-bolt. There's four flat washers on there total. And so I'll just put everything in between the flat washers. The coaxial cable is going to be connected directly to the antenna. And I'm going to tell you, I'm going to be honest with you. According to the ARRL antenna handbook, I'm not doing this correctly. I should be using a matching capacitor at the feed point. Honestly, no one that I know of, including myself, actually uses that matching capacitor. Instead, we just adjust the length of the antenna. And so the radials are going to start out again. Calculated length was 8'3". If you're building a CB antenna, you're going to mount this up on a mast. Make the radials 102 inches long. Your vertical element, start out for the CB band, start out about 105 or 108. If you're going to put it on a mast, go ahead and make it a little bit longer before you put it up. You are going to have to take it up and down a few times to adjust the height of the vertical element. Now the center of the coaxial cable, of course, the shield goes to the U-bolt along with the radials. You can either drill a hole and use a machine screw or a sheet metal screw and a lock washer and use a ring connector and attach your coaxial cable like that if you want to. Again, I don't want to drill a hole in this tubing, so I'm using a hose clamp, and I just need enough room to slip that on like that, and I'm just going to attach the center of the coax directly to the to the clamp. I still have to make the coaxial cable. We just take the end of the cable. I'll come down 2 or 3 inches. Kind of twist the cable a little bit. Just kind of score a line across there. Take the razor blade and X-Acto knife and slice down the side of it. It's kind of some old looking coax. Hopefully it's still good. Okay, the next thing to do, push the braid down. Like that. Take the awl. Separate some wire. Kind of bend the cable. Try to get the awl down inside of it. Then when you get the awl down in between the dielectric and the shield, bend the cable like that and pull out on the cable. Just work it out of the shield. And pull that out like that. Stretch our cable back out down here at the bottom. Kind of twist it. Clean up any wires that are sticking out. Okay, and there's the coaxial cable split, separated. I'll get ready to put a ring connector on there. And I have trimmed these down to about 2 inches, about 50 centimeters. I stripped about 3/4 of an inch off here on the center. If I put some solder on there, I may not be able to get my ring connector on there. So I'm just going to have to stuff it on there. Looks see if we get some solder down inside of it.
Now this is the spot for the antenna. This is where the old storage building used to be. I should be far enough away from the other antennas that I shouldn't interfere with them. And I'm going to need about 50 feet of cable to run the feed line from here over to the tower. So I'll get things set up here and get the mast put in the ground.
You want it to stick up a few inches up above the ground. You don't want it completely on the ground. And let's see, we need to hook up, make the connections here. Radials and stretch the radials out, and I'm going to have two running north and south and two running east and west. And what I'll do is I'll just take a staple, stretch out the wire whichever direction it's going here, and just kind of go ahead and staple it right there at the base of the antenna like that to the ground, and then stretch out the wire and put a staple at the other end. And there's the antenna all set up. It's not very tall. Starting out at 8 feet 7 inches, and that's just kind of a random number. I'm going to check the SWRs and we'll tune it from there. But there it is, all set up. Let's see, I'm at 26.4. I see 1.1. Well, I can work the entire CB band, 1.2 to 1.0 on the citizens band. Now let's go up here, 28 megahertz. I've got 1.0, 28.3, 1.0, 28.5, 1.0. 28.65, 1.1, 28.7, 1.1, 28.8, 1.1. Let's go up to 29 megahertz. 29.85, they're 1.3. Okay, I'm going to use the rig to check the SWRs from. See what it sees. See, I'm on CW. On full power, full carrier. Yeah, they're flat. 28.3. Let's go up. 28.4. They're flat. 28.5, no change. Looks good. The Kilo Golf Zero Zulu Zulu.
Go ahead.
Yeah, what was the call again? Is it November 6th, X-ray Romeo Charlie? This is Kilo Golf Zero Zulu Zulu.
The call is M6 X-ray Charlie Romeo. The name is Jim.
Okay, hello Jim. The name here is Dave. I'm located in the state of Kansas. I'm trying out an antenna that I just put up and wanted to see how well it was working. A big signal on you. You're in here in the Kansas City, Kansas area, 5.9 plus. Okay, thank you very much for the strong and clear. Can you give me a signal report?
I can't see the meter because I am blind, but I would say 5.9 is a very, very good signal.
Okay, I understand. I understand that. Okay, well, as long as you've got a good signal and good copy on me here, I'm playing around with a little experimental antenna. It's just a monoband 10-meter ground-mounted vertical antenna.
Doing a good job for you, that's for sure. And
EQSL,
sir.
Yes, Jim. Postcard only.
Well, it doesn't make any difference for me. What I do is get a bunch of cards, I put them in my little book, and then I just, I show people that, oh, this is where you talk to.
Roger, roger. Me too. Also enjoy that. I have a few notebooks filled up with QSL cards and have enjoyed collecting them over the years. And it is a lot of fun to show friends and neighbors, all the different places that you've talked to. Anyways, Jim, okay, I won't hold it up here too long. I know there was somebody else that was in there with you. Good working you, though. You have a good strong signal here in the Kansas City, Kansas area, Jim. Over. And what, Jim, give me your location again.
Roger. I'm in San Dimas, California. I'm in a retirement home in San Dimas, California. And it's in the, on the call book or whatever. If you look at me, you'll find my picture and all that stuff on there.
Roger, roger, roger. Okay, Jim. All right, thanks a lot for helping me out here, and like I said, it's just testing out the new antenna. You and I have pretty good band conditions. The band is, I've kind of tuned around and listened for a while, and the band is kind of up and down. I was hearing a station down in San Salvador. Boy, he was 5.7 one moment, then he dropped down to almost next to nothing, and 5 minutes later, his signal is back up. So 10 meters is kind of up and down a little bit, but it's kind of held up for here long enough for a quick QSO. Okay, Jim, listen, 7-3, I'll turn it back to you there for another one. November 6, X-ray, Charlie Romeo from Kilo Golf Zero, Zulu, Zulu.
Okay, thank you very much for the QSO. Have a great afternoon out there. M6 X-ray, Charlie Romeo, Jim in San Dimas, California. San Dimas, California, standing by.
Okay, Jim, 7-3, November 6, X-ray, Charlie Romeo from Kilo Golf Zero, Zulu, Zulu. And so there's the ground-mounted vertical antenna. And these are, they're pretty nice little antennas. They're not the strongest signal, and you know, there are maybe times when you may be having a little bit of problem hearing someone. They do work better if they're elevated. But they can be conveniently mounted on the ground, and pretty easy to make one for 10 through 20 meters. 40 meters is a little bit tall, but you can have a lot of fun with a ground-mounted vertical antenna. So give one a try, guys. They're really a lot of fun. 7-3, I'll see you later down the log from KG0ZZ.